matter what time of the day it is that you're watching this. My name is Clarissa Young, and I'm your FAB motivator. That's F-A-B. I help other women find acceptable balance when it comes to health, wellness, and prosperity. I'd like to thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for liking, for commenting, for sharing my videos, and joining me along my journey. Happy, happy Saturday. Happy, happy Saturday. Yes, 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 yes. On Saturdays, we work out in our chair. I hope you are ready. Yes, yes, yes. This Saturday, we are going to be doing what I call chair insanity. Yes, yes, yes. We're going to be doing some cardio in our chair at the end of the day. Make it to be your very own. Make it to be your very own. We are going to be working out in our chair this morning, doing some chair cardio. Chair cardio this morning. Happy Saturday. Shouts out to you guys that's watching us live. Shouts out to you guys that's catching us on the replay. And shouts out to you guys that's watching us on YouTube. Yes, yes, yes. If you want to join us live, come on over. We're inside Facebook. It's out of our Fab Work Sisters Group. That's F-A-B-W-E-R-K. Sisters Group inside of Facebook. We would love for you to come join us live inside of our Fab Work Sisters Group. Let me say good morning. And then we're going to get ready to get right into it. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Yes, yes, yes. Good morning, Miss Sharon. Good morning, Miss Beverly. Miss Beverly, I'm not sure if you saw us, but yesterday we did an amazing arm workout in the chair. It was killer. It was killer, but it was in the chair yesterday. Go check it out. Good morning, Miss Rochelle. Good morning, Miss Joyce. Good morning, Miss Cynthia. Good morning, Miss Sharon. Good morning, Miss Valerie. Good morning, Miss Rochelle. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on in, guys. Happy, happy Saturday. Let me make sure while you guys jump in. Let me make sure. Looks like we're good. Hey, if you did not see the post, just to let you know, I will be traveling September 3rd through September the 9th about. And so there will be no lives. Check out my YouTube channels. Check out the videos that's inside of the groups and do those videos. Or check out some other people on YouTube, whichever. But for those days, I will be traveling. And I don't want to promise you that I'll be able to go live. So if I can go live, I will go live. But as of now, I'm going to say there will be no live. So September the 3rd through the 9th, I will be traveling. So 9 times out of 10, there will be no lives during those times. But we are going to continue. I will continue to post. And I will continue to put the 90-day transformation information. But however, I do not know if the situation will allow me to be able to stream live. So keep that in mind, okay, guys? Good morning, good morning. Some more people jumped on. And we're about to get started.
Hey!
Y'all ready? Good morning, good morning, good morning, Miss Valerie. Good morning, Miss Roxanne. Good morning, Miss Verencia. Good morning, Miss Julie. Good morning, Miss Stacy. Good morning, Miss Johnny. She's celebrating her birthday for the next 2 months. Good morning, Miss Michelle. Good morning, Miss Brenda. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Let's go. If there's some more of you here and I did not say your name, Facebook did not let me know that you were here. So say good morning to me so I can say good morning back to you. Good morning, good morning. All right, let me start our timer. At the end of the day, have fun.
Starting chair insanity.
Do what you can do. Good morning, happy Saturday. I got my lipstick on. Yeah, that's how I was just about to say, Miss Stacy. I got the lipstick on. Throw your lipstick on. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's go. Warm it up. Let's go. crunch it. Knee raise.
Relax.
Set three.
Ah, awesome job. Awesome job. Thank you. Let's go. Bye. No, I'm not alone.
Let's go. One,
awesome job. High five. If you're just joining us at the end of each workout, we high five each other. High five. Let's breathe and cool it down. Awesome workout. Please know, Miss Ramona and anybody else that's just joining us, because we're working out in a chair, like people be like, oh, you working out in a chair, like that mean you're not working out. Listen, because you're working out in a chair does not mean that you're not working out, okay? We're sweating, heart rates are up. It just means that you're not doing all the impact on your joints, okay? We're still working, okay? So don't feel defeated. Don't feel upset like we're in the chair and I'm still tired. That's the point. Great job. Let's breathe. You're being nicer to your body, okay? Breathe. Breathe. Awesome job. Arms up. Great job. Stretch and breathe. Great job. Take the right arm, drop it down, pull it back. Let's finish. breathe again.
I said everything attached to you wins. Do you want to get there with me?
Breathe again.
Come on, let's do time. Everything attached to you wins. I just gotta say, it's your win to see. It's your win to see. You've got God to carry you. You've got God to carry you. That's what he's gonna do tonight. Cause you can't afford to lose again. You can't afford to lose again.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, no matter what time of day it is that you're watching this. My name is Clarissa Young and I'm your FAB motivator. That's FAB. I help the woman find acceptable balance when it comes to health, wellness, and prosperity. I like to thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for liking, for commenting, for sharing my videos and joining me along my journey. Thank you so much for being here with me. If you're watching the videos on YouTube, we are inside of our Fab Work Sisters group. That's FABWERK Sisters group on Facebook. Come on and join us while we work out live. This morning the spirit led me to go search for this song this morning. And this song is You Will Win by Jacqueline Kerr. And I had stopped talking as much on the bottom of my videos because YouTube don't be nice to me at the bottom of the songs, but as well as today, the spirit led me to sit down and talk. I don't have anything in particular to talk about, but this song is your winning season. You know, everything attached to me wins. And when I say me, I mean us, you know, and sometimes we just need to be reminded that you know, that we look at certain situations and certain things around us, and it just, we feel defeated. We feel like, let me turn. Give me a minute to just hear exactly what it is that God wants me to see. It's like even our message for this week that we're doing our 90-day transformation is we have to be careful sometimes what we ask for God to take away from us. You know, the message is, you know, some of the things that we ask for God to take away from us looks like weeds, and though they may be weeds, but a lot of times there's something for us to learn from there. And that, you know, he gives the illustration of doing pull-ups, and it says that even those tough situations that we go through, there's something to be learned, there's something to increase us in there. I'm not done just yet, baby. Give me a few more minutes, okay? Thank you. And that, you know, in every situation that we go through, that there's something to benefit from us, you know. And so when I know me personally, when I go through something, I try to remember, because when you're going through it, you know, it could be tough. You know, it could be tough to go through a situation and remember that everything attached to me wins, that all things are working for my good, that, you know, even this is going to work out for my best. You know, sometimes it can be hard to remember that, you know, but I try my best to say that to myself, you know, that Clarissa, everything works out, you know, for my good. And that just trust and believe. And one of the things he said, continue to sow and stop sorting. you know, just continue to believe and to speak to God and stop trying to figure out everything and stop trying to map out everything and stop trying to tell God, you know, well, God, remove this and don't do this and don't do that, because sometimes some of the stuff that we're asking for him to take away is going to be the very thing that he needs to use to uplift you, or it's going to be the very thing that he needs to use to be able to bless you. You know, let's use my weight. You know, me getting up to 515 pounds is the very thing that he's using to bless my life tremendously. And so it looked like it was going to be the very thing to kill me, the very thing to wipe me out. Or let's look at the arthritis in my knees. You know, it looks like it's the very thing that introduced me to the chair workouts, you know. And when people on Facebook and they notice me, a lot of people remember me as the girl that does the chair workouts, you know. And so that's the very thing that he's using to bless me with, you know, or you know, just so many different things that I wanted to pluck out and to take away and say, Lord, take this thing from me, you know. And he's sorting it out and he's working it, and you know, he always tells us, you know, that we know that our life was planned out before we was born, and that he knows our best interests. And so, you know, I'm learning to say, okay, God, I know that you have a plan for my life. And I try to bargain sometimes, right? Anybody try to bargain? And say, well, God, if you could, like, could it happen this way? And, you know, sometimes you have to just step back and say, well, God, okay, I throw my hands up. And I know at the end of the day, you know what's best for my life, and you know the right way to make things happen. And I promise I'm going to go back and read all of your comments, you know, and you know the best way for things to happen. So I just want to say to anybody that's going through something to continue to hang on, continue to pray, and know why you're going through a situation. And trust me, I promise you, I get on here and I smile and I motivate you and I encourage you. I promise you, I go through stuff, and I promise you, sometime with the same breath that I encourage you, I go through stuff at the very single same breath. And so it's because I know sometimes you can sit back and you can say, girl, yeah, you can tell me to smile, but you don't understand. You know, you don't understand that I'm going through blase, blase, blase. Or you don't understand that, you know, my light's about to get shut off. Or you don't understand that my kids is going through X, Y, Z. Or you, and I'm not saying I'm going through all of this, right? Or you don't understand that my husband is doing such and such. Or you don't understand that this is going on. Or you don't understand that this is going on. But I'm telling you, I go through stuff as well. I go through stuff as well. And with the same breath that I come in here and I smile and I uplift you and I tell you to come in here and pray to God, I wipe my tears and I say, Lord, I'm believing in you, and I know if I continue to have faith, you will work this thing out. And I'm like, Lord, just increase my faith, Lord. Increase my strength, Lord. Increase my belief in you. And I'm learning to not pray necessarily to say, Lord, take this thing away, take this thing away, take this thing away, but give me the faith, give me the perseverance, give me the strength, give me the ability to be able to work through this. And I'm learning to say, okay, Lord, what was the lesson that I was supposed to learn through that trial? What was it that I was supposed to bring from here? And okay, Lord, I'm going through this thing right now. All things work for my good. So I know at the end of the day that though this situation happening right now, all things work for my good. So I'm not gonna be bothered. I'm not gonna let this situation, give me 1 minute, and you just ate breakfast. Your eggs are sitting right there. Go eat your eggs. I'm not gonna let this one situation affect my entire day, because sometimes that's how the situation that's how the situation wins. If you allow that situation, because the situation might not have won. I'm going to give you one analogy and then I'm going to go ahead and wrap the video up. I'll never forget years ago, when I was going to this one particular church, the guy gave the illustration of a lunch line. He said, like, God is trying to bless you with something, but you know, God operates on faith. He operates on faith, and you have to show faith a lot of times for him to be able to bless you. And so you're in the lunch line, and you have the servers in the cafeteria, let's say, and you're going through the lunch line to get your food, to get your blessing, and you're at the back of the line, right? And as you're in line, this is showing your faith. And so if you're complaining, if you're doubting, if you're fearful, every time that you second guess God, and this is your blessing, this is your food, this is you receiving, you have to get out of line and you have to go back to the back. And so you might have been about to get your blessing. And so let's say your blessing was your things are financially tight. And I know right now a lot of people are going through stuff financially. So let's say things were financially tight and you have been asking God, you've been saying, God, I need help with this rent. Things are tight right now. I need you to help me with the rent. And God said, okay, Alicia, I'm going to send somebody to be able to help you, to be able to cover your rent. I hear you, Alicia, because he said, ask and you shall receive. And he said, as soon as you ask for it, I'm going to give it to you. And so he said, as soon as you ask for it, I'm going to give it to you. And he's working on stuff for you in the background. So he said, okay, Alicia, now I'm going to go speak to Kim. And I'm speaking to Kim, and Kim is going to have to speak to Tasha, and Tasha's going to have to speak to, so I'm doing some stuff. And so as I'm doing some stuff, you're working your way up in the line, and I'm doing some stuff in the background. But however, Alicia is not starting to be doubtful because she don't see the stuff that's happening in the unseen arena. So while she's doing stuff in the unseen, while she's here in the world, life and death is in the power of the tongue. While she's here in the world, she's speaking stuff. Oh, I don't know. Oh, woe is me. Oh, my bills ain't gone. Now God gotta come counteract all the stuff that you're saying. Now your blessing was here in the lunch line, but now God got to come counteract everything that you're saying. So instead of him being able to come and let you be able to move forward, now he got to go fight off all this other doubts and all this other stuff that you're saying. So it's instead of you being able to continue, I hope y'all get what I'm saying. So instead of you being able to continue to move forward and be able to get your rent paid because he said you was coming and he's working on stuff, but instead of him being able to come, now he got to stop. He gotta stop this, and he gotta fight off all of this other stuff that you started, these seeds that you start planting with your doubts and so forth, you know? And so just life and death is in the power of the tongue. And if you ask, you shall receive. You shall receive, and just make sure that everything you speak is positive, because life and death is in the power of the tongue, and we go through stuff. We go through stuff. I understand. When I'm up here and I'm telling you, believe, and you shall receive. That I go through stuff at the same time. I'm not inevitable. I'm not mighty woman. Okay, I go through stuff, and I live some of the same stuff that you guys live. And I'm some of the same stuff. I'm constantly saying to myself, all things work for my good. All things work for my good. I cannot outgive my God. I'm a giver. I believe in giving and helping other people. You know, I can't outgive my God. And just different little stuff that I'm constantly saying and trying to recheck myself. Okay? So I love you all so much. I love you all so much. Everything attached to us wins. Everything attached to us wins is the word for today. It's a word for today. And like Miss Tasha said, we have to speak it over our life. We have to speak positivity over our life. Okay? Love you so much. I promise to go back and read all of the other comments as well. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday. Continue to work on your Biggest Loser challenge. Getting the rest of these pounds off. And I will see you guys on Monday for our Fab Fit test. Okay? Love you. Talk to you later. All right? Bye-bye.